Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. In this video, I want to briefly introduce the idea of universal grammar. So, universal grammar is a theory proposed by Noam Chomsky that suggests that all human languages share certain features. Now, people often misinterpret this as meaning that all languages share grammar and that they share the same grammatical rules. And of course, this is not the case, and this is not what universal grammar refers to. So in order to understand this idea of universal grammar, we're going to start with the idea that all children acquire language. Right? So all children will acquire the language that they're exposed to. And it doesn't matter what that specific language is, children will learn it, and they'll learn it essentially naturally. It will emerge automatically. And the rules of grammar will also emerge naturally. Children will come to understand how to express things in that language, and they'll learn the rules of grammar in that specific language. So this is support for this idea of the language acquisition device. And this is this idea from Chomsky that we must have some predisposition for learning language that other animals don't have, right? If language naturally emerges in pretty much all people who are exposed to language, then this means that our brains are prepared to learn language. We have a natural sort of predisposition for acquiring language. So the idea of a language acquisition device suggests that we are prepared to acquire language. And again, this is not a specific structure in the brain or something. When we talk about this language acquisition device, it's sort of a general idea of, well, our brains are prepared in some way to acquire language. It's not about a specific, you know, region of the brain that's doing this. Okay, so well, now we have this problem of, okay, we say we all acquire language if we're exposed to it, and we have some preparation, some predisposition to acquire language. Well, how can we be prepared to acquire language if languages are all different? In other words, if I take an infant and I raise that infant in Japan, then, you know, he'll grow up speaking Japanese. Or if I raise him in Russia, he'll grow up speaking Russian. Or if I raise him in Germany, he'll grow up speaking German. And it's like, how can he be prepared? How can we say that he has a biological predisposition to acquiring language, and yet he doesn't know what that language is going to be? So how does this work? Well, the idea would be there must be some underlying features of language that are all the same, and that we're prepared to acquire any language because all languages have certain things in common. So the idea here is that we're prepared to acquire certain types of grammatical rules, right? But not the specific grammatical rules. So in other words, languages must share certain features, certain types of rules are common to all languages, and our brains are prepared to acquire those types of rules, but that the specific rules will vary. So in other words, the idea that, okay, in a specific language, maybe we learn that the adjective comes before the noun. And in some other language, it could be completely the opposite, right? The noun could come before the adjective. And so the specific rules vary. But the idea of adjectives is the same. The idea that we use some word to describe some other word, that we can change some mental representation of something by adding an adjective to it, or that we can use verbs to express things, or that we have different tenses to talk about the time periods in which things occurred. These are things that all languages are going to have. And these are the things that our brains are predisposed to picking up on. Now, the specific ways that we express it, of course, are going to vary, and we're not born with some pre-programmed rules about grammar, but rather that we're sort of programmed to acquire any specific grammatical rules because all of those rules will follow similar patterns, similar types of rules in the existence of things like adjectives or adverbs or nouns. So that's really the idea of universal grammar. It's often misinterpreted, but hopefully this made it a little bit clearer. So I hope you found this helpful. If so, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.